Hi everybody, we're here this morning to talk about the Kaf. The Kaf to me is a very sweet letter. It's very comforting. Anyway, now is the time for you to get your art supplies, your crayons or pencils or acrylics or whatever, and just pause this and then you can go back to it. So Kaf is the 11th letter in the Hebrew alphabet and has a numerical value of 20. It means palm of the hand, spoon or container. Here's some of my Kafs. And Kaf makes the Kaf, if it has a, well, you'll see, here's the letter, okay? So if Kaf has a dot in the middle, it sounds like the K in kitchen. And if it doesn't have a dot in the middle, it sounds like, sort of like the chet, which is a chet, that sound. So here's another Kaf. See, it's really easy to draw. It's just a backward C. And here's another one. These are just all my ideas with the Kaf. And here's the one I want to get to. Okay. Here is the Kaf. And this is me. And I'm in the palm of the Kaf is in the palm of the hand. Actually, the Kaf means the palm of the hand, and I am inside meditating. It's a wonderful place to meditate. And here's another one showing the Kaf in the palm of the hand. Kaf is really one of my really special letters. Oh, and here, what I wanted to say is the Kaf is one of five letters that has two forms. There's the Kaf, Mem, Nun, Pe, and Sadi. And they all have two forms. So this is the, if it comes at the end of the word, so the Kaf is called Kaf Sofit, meaning it's the finish of the word. And so when it's in the beginning and middle of the word, it's this shape. And if it's at the end of the word, it's this shape. And the same thing goes for the letter Mem, Nun. Each one of them has a final or a sofit letter at the end of the word, and it's different in shape from the regular letter. The first time the Kaf is mentioned in the Bible is here, when it says can you see? Where is it? Backwards. Oh shoot! Let me put my finger there first. Here it is. And there it is. But you see, oh, is my finger showing? No. Okay. Okay, now I've got it. Here it says, Bekaf. Or in this case, it would be because the B has a, or the bait has a dot in it, it would be, and it the Kaf does not, it would be Bekaf. And see all these other little dots underneath the letters? Those are the vowels that change the sound of the letter. Those are the vowels. So if it's written with a, why is this so blurry? They don't show up enough for me to explain that. Okay. And Isaiah. I have it marked. 49:16. It says, God tells Israel, people of Israel that he is holding him, he is holding him in the palm of his hand. It says, I engraved, so this is the word for engraved, and this is the word for kafim. This is the word for engraved. Okay? And before that is kafim. I have engraved on the palms of my hands. I have engraved on the palms of my hands. I have engraved you on the palms of my hands. Isn't that wonderful? Yeah, I just get so thrilled with that. So kaf for the first as a word, each letter has spells out in the alphabet. So it has the letter, but then the name, the letter is also a word. So kaf is palm of the hand. So we're going to do a short meditation now. I really love the kaf because, as I said before, it is a very sweet and calm and beautiful letter. But to me, the calmness is the comforting, is the... So anyway, why don't you close your eyes and we'll see where it takes us today. So you concentrate on the kaf. Hopefully one that you've written yourself or drawn or painted. And the kaf is, well, as usual, I am in the kaf. The kaf is very special to me because it's where I can feel my feelings. And sometimes, as today, the kaf closes around me, so I'm in a circle. And here I can cry. Or be angry. Or whatever emotions on mind. Today, it's, I'm sad. I didn't know that until I got in here. And so why don't you sit in your kaf? Or not. You can also walk around the kaf and say the kaf is multicolored on the front. Well, why don't you see what it looks like on the back? Why is it kind of magenta pink? Now I'd like you to start coming back into your body. You can wiggle your toes, your fingers, and then you can open your eyes. So as I said, I love the kaf because I love all the letters in a different way. Each one is different to me. And I love the kaf because it is so comforting and because I feel so safe in it. Anyway, so that's the end of this meditation. I look forward to seeing you next week when we talk about the Lamed, which is also a very special letter. And if any of you would like to join my other clients, just follow the directions underneath. I have my cell phone and an email, and I can do this with you one at a time. And you can check me out on Jewish Meditation and Practical Spirituality, and you can type that in and use the Facebook page for that. Anyway, I look forward to seeing you next week. This has been very special. Thank you for listening.